Chegues tarde, mas canta só mais um pouquinho comigo, tá bem?
Tá bem, papai.
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. always made my troubles feel so small. And you were always there to catch me when I'd fall.
Feeling Let us stand to begin our liturgy. Church to pray for our beloved Manuel. We pray that God will give him eternal rest. We pray also for his family and for you, each one of you, that God will give you peace and strength into your hearts. Remember, this is act of faith. We came to church to pray, faith in Jesus and resurrection. Let's make our prayers special. Let's open the booklet in our hands in page 10. 10, the funeral service for a man. Let us pray in loud voice, all of us, and because the prayers are between two congregation, the priest and the people, it's very important all of us to pray in loud voice together when it comes to our turns. I see that you are too close to each other. If you can keep social distance, I know it's you're still family, but it's for your safety, you never know. And please keep the mask on your mouth and nose the whole time. Only when we come to read, we take it off so you can hear us. That's why I don't put it. But for the rest, please keep it the whole time in the church. Let us pray. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. O Lord, make all the faithful departed who sleep in your hope and through faith worthy to find rest and happiness with your saints, especially our brother Emmanuel, who we remember today before your majesty. You are the good one and the lover of all people. We offer the glory and thanks to you, to your Father, and to your living Holy Spirit, now and forever. You may be seated. On page 11, Psalm 51, when you see one star on the left is my turn and two stars is yours. Have mercy on me, O God, in your kindness, in your compassion, blot out my offense. Wash me more and more from my guilt, and cleanse me from my sin. Purify me, and I shall be clean. O wash me, I shall be whiter than snow. Together. From my sins, turn away your face, and blot out all my guilt. Do not cast me away from your presence, nor deprive me of your Holy Spirit. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Leanne, please come forward for the first prayer.
With your blessing, have mercy on us, O Lord, and help us. Lord, in your mercy, enable our brother Manuel, who has left us to be admitted into the abode of life, into the assembly of the saints, who have pleased you from the beginning. We offer glory to you now and forever.
Amen. Page 12, let us pray together. Alleluia, Lord, we your people ask you to receive your servant in the gates of paradise with the saints. Grant him forgiveness, have compassion, wipe away his sins, for he has loved you. Open the gates, count him, Lord, on the judgment day, with the saints and the righteous ones. May he praise and worship you and thank you, O Lord. Page 14. Out of the death I cry to you, O Lord. Lord, hear my voice. If you, O Lord, should mark our guilt, Lord, who would survive? My soul is waiting for the Lord. I count on his word. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Celeste, please come forward for the second prayer.
With your blessing, Lord, have mercy on us. O Lord, and help us. Lord, save our brother Manuel, whom you have taken from us by your will from the power of death. Rescue the soul of your worshipper from the dwelling of death, and let him dwell in your heavenly kingdom. Make him worthy to enter your paradise on the day of your manifestation with the righteous and the saints. We thank you with joy and glorify you, your Father and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. Page 15 together. To God be glory. Grant our place in heaven, Lord, for this your servant who has gone before us to your throne of glory. Accept him, Lord. He has shed your body and your blood clothed in majesty. Now receive him with the sheep, your faithful servants, in your kingdom with the saints who glorified you. Happy the man who fears the Lord, who takes delight in all his commands. He is a light in the darkness for the upright, he generous, merciful, and just. Open-handed, he gives to the poor, his justice stands firm forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Together, grant rest and hope and peace and joy to our departed one, O Lord, who ate your body, drank your blood, and died believing in your love. Hear our request, O Lord our God, have mercy on your faithful one. May he rejoice on judgment day and find himself among saints. Admit him, Lord, to paradise with all the righteous and the just, to celebrate your banquet feast with God, the Holy Trinity. Please stand. For the glory and honor of the Most Holy Trinity, may we be worthy to praise, glorify, and honor the living one who spoke and we came to life. He created Adam and fashioned him in the image of his majesty. By his command, he deprives Adam of his life and sends him back to his former state, the dust from which he was made. Then he recalls him, raises him, renews him, adorns him, and grants him an inheritance with his angels. He is the good one to whom glory and honor are due at this time and all the days of our lives, now and forever. Danny, please come forward for the cedro.
O eternal God, you are abundant in grace and truth. You are light and a new life. You are the creator of the universe, time and all that changes. You are awesome, exalted, and praised in your commands, yet patient and kind in your mercy. innermost thoughts are revealed and laid bare before you, yet your ways are unsearchable. You sent your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, into the world to conquer death and destroy hell. Through Christ you announced life to every soul who calls upon you. Now, O Lord, Maker and Ruler of heaven and earth, we offer your praise for the soul of our brother Manuel, who has left this earthly life for pilgrimage so that the angels of peace may guide him to the place of rest. O lover of all people, grant him the pardon for his sins, extend your all-merciful right hand to him and rescue him from the second death. Remember your holy promise to him and to us. Lord, be his companion and guardian so that he may reach the blissful dwelling place. Forget his adversity and sorrow, and may he find rest with the saints in eternal glory. And for us, your worshippers, grant us to be ready to live a pure life in you, free from sin, and we will leave here in peaceful departure and deserve to enter your eternal kingdom. Then we shall glorify you with your only Son and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen. You may be seated. Lord, we beseech you, through the fragrance of this incense offered before you, accompany our brother Emmanuel, who has departed from us. Lead him to the blissful dwelling places of the saints. forgive all his sins and offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord. With him is due glory to you and to your Holy Spirit, now and forever. Page 25 together, from my youth and up to now. Your cross lightens up the dark with death shadow all around. Save me from the torment's day. Lord, your mercy I have found. Nicola, please come forward for the reading.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 12 to 20. With your blessing, Father. Brothers and sisters, now if Christ be preached that he rose again from the dead, how do some among you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? But if there be no resurrection of the dead, then Christ is not risen again. And if Christ had not been risen again, then is our preaching in vain, and your faith in vain? Yea, and we are found false witnesses of God, because we have given testimony against God that he hath raised up Christ, whom he hath not raised, if the dead rise not again. For if the dead had not risen again, neither is Christ raised again. And if Christ had not been raised again, your faith is in vain, for you are yet in your sins. Then they also that are fallen asleep in Christ are perished. If in this life only we have hope in Christ, we are all of men most miserably. But now Christ is risen from the dead, the first fruits of them that sleep.
Please stand for the gospel. Peace be with you. From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Mark. The Lord Jesus says, but of that day or hour no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Be watchful, be alert. You do not know when the time will come. It is like a man traveling abroad. He leaves home and places his servants in charge, each with his work, and orders the gatekeeper to be on the watch. Watch, therefore, you do not know when the Lord of the house is coming, whether in the evening or at midnight or at cockcrow or in the morning. May he not come suddenly and find you sleeping. What I say to you, I say to all, watch. This is the truth. Peace be with you. You may be seated. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. In a moment like this, it's never been easy to say anything, especially the pain is strong in your hearts, our hearts. The pain is deep, especially someone we love and we lose. It's not easy. But at the same time, what I need you to take with you from this church is two messages. First one is, the prayer we offer today is not only for Manuel, it's also for you, especially for his family, because when we come to pray, it's an act of faith. And when we have faith, it means we come in because we know that we believe in Jesus, we believe in his promise, we believe in his salvation and his resurrection. And this is very important because this will lead us to know that Manuel is not dead. He's alive, and you will meet again. When we all leave this earth and we go to eternal life, we meet with each other in better place, we call it. We call it heaven, where God is. And this is act of faith, will lead us to give us strength into our lives and peace into our hearts. It's very important. And that's why the prayer is for you also, to have this peace, to make sure that all this life, all these years that Manuel spent here on earth, didn't go for nothing. It went for something beautiful. He's going to better life, to eternal life. The same for you, is keeping you behind as a flourishing family in the midst of the church. This is the meaning why we come to church and why we pray. It's very important. And most of it, the second fact we learn today and the message we take from the church is that when we leave this life, we have a journey. And the journey leads us to be responsible for our lives and the life that we pray for. Today we pray for Manuel, asking God to give him eternal rest, because we know that in our Catholic teaching, in our dogmas, we believe in a place called purgatory. This place, all the souls will go through so they can be purified and cleansed from all the mistakes and sins being committed during this life, so they can be worthy to be in the presence of God himself. So it's very important. As much as you love Manuel, as much as you care for him, as much as you pray for him, as much as you want to be united with him, as much as you pray for him, as much as you show that you are one family and you love each other and you stay together and you stick with each other, as much as you pray for him. This is very important message to show that he's not by himself, you're still with him, you're still as a family, connected and united with each other through the belief we have in our heart, the faith we carry, the faith in Jesus Christ. Something beautiful God gave us as a gift to tell us you are not alone. You are not left behind. You're always someone with you. If no one is with you, even God is with you. That's why it is also responsibility for each one of us to be ready, like the gospel taught us today. Alert, be watchful, watch, be careful with your life, because we saw that how much life during these days, especially during these days, as we have the virus all over and we have sickness all over, people dies, but it shows us how much we are fragile, how much we are so easy to leave this life. Small thing can change. Heart stop, virus kill us, anything happen, accident happened. In life, we are not sure if we can see tomorrow. So we are not in control. Who is in control is the one we came to church to say, take care of us. We love you, we honor you, we believe in you. And today we came to church to offer our beloved Manuel, so take care of him in his final journey. Do you agree with me? This is our faith. And this is the beauty of our faith, that in moment like this, in the sadness taking over our hearts, now we have hope. We have something is given us to push that, to say that, don't be afraid. I'm here for you. Don't feel lonely. I'm here for you. Don't feel that you go into perish, because it's not. I'm here for you. I am the life. I'm giving you life. I am the truth. I'm giving you the truth. I am everything for you. I'm giving you everything to stand up, be united with Jesus, be united with him. Especially we are in the church of his mother, the Mother Mary, that you know the mother will never leave her children. And now she is in both hands, Jesus and Mary, taking care of him in his journey. That's why we pray that God will forgive all his sins and mistakes in this life and prepare him to enjoy eternal life later on, where we will meet again. Amen. Let us open page 28 and let us pray together. Give rest to your servant, O Lord, in the kingdom of heaven with all your saints and forever. O Son, at the sound of your voice, the departed will rise. Hear our prayer for the soul who has left us. O Christ, you once prayed to be spared from the anguish of death. Spare us now from it, Lord. Have compassion. O Lord, we exalt all the saints and your mother, and ask them to pray for us all and our loved ones. I will ask you all to stand, please. With this prayer, now after we pray this prayer, I will be blessing the coffin with the holy water as a reminder for Manuel baptism and his unity with Jesus in this life and the life beyond. Together, blessed are you, gracious Father, God of love. You have rescued us from death. Save your servant from the dark. Save him from the blazing fire. Grant to him eternal life. Lord, receive your servant here. He was baptized in your name. Wash away his sin and shame. Write his name among your saints. Page 32, the second paragraph, let us pray three times. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, a strong one. Holy are you, immortal one. Have mercy on us. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, a strong one. Holy are you, immortal one. Have mercy on us. Holy are you, O God. Holy are you, a strong one. Holy are you, immortal one. Have mercy on us. Page 34. Eternal rest grant to him, O Lord. May his soul rest in peace. Peace be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, amen. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Jesus Christ, our Lord and God, you became incarnate and tasted bitter death for our salvation. You have mercy on each soul who has departed from this perishable world after having died with you in the waters of baptism, and having received your pure body and holy blood, nourishment of blessings and the sign of forgiveness. Have mercy on our brother Manuel, who has gone from among us. Take him to the heavenly dwellings with your righteous and saints, those who have kept your commandments and accomplished your will. Then with them he will give thanks and praise to your holy name, and that your blessed Father and your living Holy Spirit, now and forever. You may be seated for the eulogy. Roger, please come forward.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Into your hands, loving Father, we commend our dear Manuel. In the sure and certain hope that together with all those who have died in your risen Son, will rise with him one last day. We give you thanks for the great blessings which you bestowed upon our dear Manuel in his life. And we give you thanks that the wonderful memories Manuel has given us, which are living signs of your grace and goodness to us. This is from Angie and the three sons to Manuel. The most important thing we can say about a dad is that his family was his life. He loved his wife and his kids more than anybody will ever comprehend. Even though he treated outsiders better than us at times, we know in our hearts he always loved us more and would choose us first over anyone else. There are no boundaries, hurdles, or obstacles our dad would not overcome to ensure that we had food on the table. He would make sure that we ate first before he would start. He always tried his best to give us the basic needs of life, and the one thing he did really well was provide us and protect us. The many military generals would envy. This love also extended to the rest of the family and even to his friends. And he would invite the world over to our home for every possible occasion. His philosophy during the festive events or family gatherings for any nature was the more the merrier. He loved to have his entire family near him. These are the values and traditions that will live on forever in us. Generosity personified our dad. He never said no to anyone in need, and at times making problems for himself in the process of helping others. But nonetheless, he would do it. That's the kind of man he was. He had a heart of gold and would give the shirt off his back to anyone who needed it. Ever the eternal jokester and prankster, we loved the good laugh and would often do the most ridiculous things to entertain everyone. He was a good man, the kind of father that figure that any family would be proud of. He was not by any means perfect, but then again, who is? Nonetheless, he was our imperfect dad, not anyone else's. Our dad was brought up old school, and that wasn't the most affectionate man. He wasn't the type to hug and kiss us regularly, but more new age fathers would. But his actions and support of us showed us every day how loved we were. We may not have always had the best of everything, but we always had what we needed, and we knew that our dad was always there, trying his best in providing for us, supporting us, defending us, and we could not ask for anything better. You will forever live in our hearts. We love you always, Dad. This is from Fernando Amar. I never thought that I would be standing here telling everyone who knew you just how much your departure from this earth shocked and affected me. I still think I'm having a nightmare. We had our good and bad times, but nothing stopped us from being there for one another when we needed. You had a heart of gold towards everyone, and how you are reaping that, and how you are reaping what you sowed on earth. May you find true happiness in the heavenly home. You shall be truly missed by all, my brother. Lord, you promised us there are many places in your Father's house. As we begin our prayers today, we give you thanks and entrust our dear Manuel into your loving care. May he rest in peace. Amen.
Amen. Our prayers for Manuel continue this coming Sunday at 10 a.m. The Mass you can attend, or is live streamed also at 10 o'clock. We offer the Mass for Manuel. You can, if you want to share, you can be in the church. It's type Our Lady of Lebanon, Malbaton. You can on Facebook or YouTube follow the live stream for the Mass for our beloved Manuel. Now I'll ask you all to stand for the final hymn. Please, Paul Bearers, please come forward so we can leave the church. We go into the cemetery in Cromfley if you want to join the family and us in the cemetery.
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will. You're gone.
can't say this to your face, but I know you hear. I'll see you again. You
I'm not afraid to die. que outrora eu plantei, meu amor, princesa dos meus sonhos, tu, oferta platina que Deus me enviou. Os meus olhos,
papai,
minha filha, eu quero viver contigo a vida inteira, cantar, brincar, ver-te sorrir à minha beira. Ai, se eu quero ver jardim, acordar de manhã, ver-te sorrir para mim. Ai, se eu quero.
Daddy, já é tarde e tenho que ir para a escola.
Eu sei, meu bem. Eu farei tudo para que não chegues tarde. Mas canta só mais um pouquinho comigo, está bem?
Está bem, papai.
Didn't know today would be your last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight. Always made my troubles feel so small, and you were always there to catch me